Hey guys, Kirkie here. Today we are starting up a new series in Terraria. But it's not going to be any old series. It is the latest version, as you can see, 1.4.2.3. And with that, we are going to be playing a new world. Not just any world, but we want a very specific seed, 0516-2011. So the name of the seed will, I don't like the object of death weed. Local of organs, cape of mastication. Should I choose that one? Because it's got a weird name. Mastication, if you don't know what it is, this is mastication. Mouth sounds. If that bothers you, then I am sorry. But not really. Jade Island, the grassy knoll. Stable expense. Give us a good one. I want something that represents this world. Prison bunker of arson. Blooming heaven of kidneys. Okay. The valley of coldness. Condemned entity. You know what? Let's go with the condemned entity. We are definitely going to be taking master mode. And I never play corruption. So we're going to play corruption. So this is a special seed. It came out once Terraria hit its 10-year anniversary, if I'm not mistaken. And this seed was thrown out there as a thank you, in a sense. It was thrown out there as a congratulations on making it 10 years. It was thrown out there for something. In any case, it's a little different than a normal seed. The only thing I know about it is, well, you'll see in just a second. I don't want to spoil it. Why can they never put the seeds where you want them? Like, put the new one up top. Don't place it. Uh-oh, where is it? Condemned entity. This will make it easier to find next time. Weird that they always do that. But as you can see, you start in the ocean. Let's get zoomed in here. This is your spawn point at the freaking ocean. And the, you know, stuff looks a little different. Hello, bunny. This is my first time seeing the new NPC. A party? Like, a festival? I love festivals! So much pink. So much glitter. It's so cheerful. Seems like without any, you know what? I agree, we need to get you some lodgings. So, I guess that'll be the first thing we do. Let's make them a nice home. So here's the other thing. It's not just the world's a little different colors. Everything's painted. So, it gives a unique look, but there, I am sure, other differences. What they are, we'll see in due time. Why would you not break out? Thank you. Let me open the chest here. It's been a while since I played, I won't lie, so I keep hitting E to interact with stuff. 64 wood, builder potions. You know what? I will take all of this and let's equip the aglet. Take this. Should we have our homes right along here on the beach? I'm thinking, die first off. Oh God. I'm thinking maybe we build our homes within this area, all through the trees. I think that'd be pretty cool. Tree, you're kind of in my way though. But yeah, I think that would be a nice little change, right? Something a little different than normal. God damn it, tree. Please, living wood, get out of my road. Oh my God, I hate these trees. I hate them so much already. We will actually go down in through one of these as well. A couple of them actually. Nope, didn't mean to bust that down out of there. What I'm looking for, well, I was really hoping for, we might luck out here. Well, that connects them. I could actually build down in here too if I wanted to. This is going to be like one of many biomes since we are in 1.4. We can take advantage of, damn it, we can take advantage of the typical setup, right? Of, you know, traveling around. Oh my God, really? All these trees connect down through here. Yay, I think. Well, this door is kind of a little bit of an awkward one. God, this is a good starting base, though, right? Oh, I'm really... This could be, like, our little cave home. Our pylon down here. Be annoying coming up out every time, though. Yep, be really annoying coming out. Oh, my God, I can't get out. But no, for real, I'm thinking we should make our first homes right along here. Oh, my God, this is picking out so slow. So let's do that. Let's make our first home. I want it up in the trees, but I don't really have a way to easily get up in the trees. So we may actually have to make the first one or two kind of low. Do I have rope? I do have rope. Let's get over onto the rope and kind of work our way up here. There we go. This will get us up here into the tree area at the very least. Hoop! And this can be where we put our first home. It's an awkward spot. I don't know if it'll count for anything, but we'll see. Let's flatten this out a little bit. And no, I'm not going to force you guys to sit here through the whole build, because that would just be mean. Oh God, I quickly forgot just how much stuff hurts you on Master Mode. Like I said, it's been a hot minute since I played. The last series that we went through. Technically, it's not the last time I played, but it's the last time I played to completion. Sorry, Squirrel. You kind of just got in the road there a little bit. Wasn't my plan to brutally murderize you, but, you know, it is what it is. I hate taking these trees down because they're pretty, and I'm afraid any of them I plant back are not going to grow like this. But I need the wood, so, you know, you got to do what you got to do. God damn it, slimes, you're too tough. One more hit and I'm donezo. You get down there, friend. I want nothing to do with you. So, yeah, the opening plan here is to get a few houses here. I think this is a good start, though, this area here. Where is our platform? Let's get them up here. So at least whoever steps out this door can have a bit of a walking zone here. A bit of a walking zone. Well, they're going to fall off if I don't fix that. I don't even know if anyone will move in. They should, though. It should, as long as I make valid housing, put the walls in and stuff, we should be golden. Should be golden, and to make it a little more golden, we need one more door. I should probably get up here to where I can make the door, shouldn't I? And we're going to need a whole buttload of wall. We also need torches, so, you know, no, I needed the door for up here, apparently. So, torches. I don't know if I'm going to have enough to make any real amount. Party time's over. At least if Little Miss Magical Girl down there dies, it won't be entirely bad, because she has a really good magic weapon and we could be super OP early on. I don't know if I would use it. I would probably use it knowing me. You know, that was me trying to play. How did you... Oh, Steampunker. Whitney at that. So Whitney's one of the developers of Terraria. That's fun. What do you have? The Clintaminator. Logic gate. Static hook. Ooh. A hook this early on. The Blendomatic. Teleporters. Decay chamber. I'm not sure what that's for. Speaking of, I mentioned I have never actually seen the princess before. Because when we went through the game, it was before 1.4.2 came out. And that was when she was introduced. I think. Maybe we did get her. I don't remember. Okay, so Royal Scepter, vanity item, 1 platinum. Freaking think I'm made of money here. So, ooh, Heart Lantern? Slime Staff? If I can get 15 gold, I'm getting that. That's a 1 in 2,500 drop. A Prince Cape, Potted Crystal Spiral. My God, there's a lot of pretty cool stuff here. Flask of Party. Melee and whip attacks cause confetti to appear. Sure, okay. What do you have for us, party girl? Just the usual. Okay. In all honesty, though, I think it's because it's been the better part of it. Actually, it probably has been over a year since my last series. I feel like I've completely forgotten how to play. So the first few episodes of this are probably going to be a little rough. So bear with me on that, guys. So, I was going to say, this should be valid housing, but no, definitely is not. Let's get our stuff down. There we are. Now they should be valid housing. I do want to double check to make sure. Suitable? Suitable. Awesome. Tree houses. Woo! Now then, I heard a star land over here. I definitely want that star. Sploosh! So I mentioned a little while back that I was going to do this run, probably a couple, 3 weeks ago. And I was asked if I was going to do anything special. Oh, I'm out of torches. If I was going to do anything special with the run, like melee only or anything like that. Ow. There's your answer. I fell and nearly died there, so there's your answer. Can I have that torch back? I need something so I can see a little bit. Hopefully, well, that went nowhere, but you know what? There's some iron right here, so let's take advantage of this. Man, I wish 1.4 had mods right now. Because if it did, we could use the vein miner. I mean, mods are in alpha now. There is technically a thing out that we could use. But, yeah, stuff's pretty broken. I'm going to grab this. I didn't mean to set down the torch. I don't necessarily need copper, but... Oh, I'm probably not going to have a way back up there. I did not think this one through. But yeah, we probably don't need copper, but it's a... Is that an enchanted sword? For realsies or fake? Why can't I go down through this one block gap? What am I standing on? Whatever. Are you kidding me? I'm guessing this is one of the perks of this world. Stuff like, you know what, copper sword? You can go down there. I have to imagine, sorry... I have to imagine these are a lot more common, or if there's any around, they are guaranteed to be good. They won't break. I can't see a damn thing, and I'm sorry because I know it's going to be the same for you guys. I want this star I heard out here too. Because we all know, I'm going to end up magic class sooner or later. Hey, Yin. Here you go, pet the bunny. Oh god, that scared the crap out of me! Hey friend, hurry up and get in here so I can... I wonder if I said... Did not mean to do that! Alright, now daytime's rolled around and I have a pretty good weapon, shockingly. Never thought I'd get this kind of lucky, like... I should not have a weapon with 23 damage on it already, not in the opening minutes of the game. This is gonna be a fun seed, I feel. But let's explore the surface a little bit. It would not jump for the life of it there. And we'll see what we can see. I was not expecting to make that jump. Okay, come on. This is so tough. But we'll get a lay of the land here. Let's grab some mushrooms so we'll be able to make some stuff down the line. Hey, ducky. Don't think you're getting away from me, jerk. Oh, no, this is much too big. I'll drown before I make it across. One thing we should do, uh-oh, please, run, get away. Oh, so powerful. We can just decimate everything. But one thing I want to do, or one thing we should do is, wait, what was I going to say? We should do something, I know that, I just don't know what the something is. We do need to kill some slimes, though. We'll let him get a little closer so I don't have to deal with that quite so bad. In such a bad way. There, now we'll make ourselves a nice bridge across here, ever so slowly. We'll do some cave spelunking as well before things... Ah, damn it! No! It's so deep! It's so cold! Let me out! While I'm slowly building this bridge across here... I will say, you want to help me on way 2.5k subs, I'd really appreciate the subscription. Yeah, thumbs up for the party seed, or whatever you want to call it. I don't even know what this seed's called. I know, the pretty seed? We could call it the pretty seed? It's probably the celebration seed or something like that. Nope, that is not my sword. Screw you. Man, I feel so OP right now. Oh. I gotta deal with the jungle already? I don't want to deal with the jungle already. I may have a decent weapon, but I don't have any one hit here and I'm done. Well, we just can't let her... Oh, God! Run! They take 60 out of us! Ah! Oh, man, if we have to... Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no. Die. Please die. Oh, not us. If we have to contend with the jungle already, we're not making it across the surface. Oh, shoot. Shoot, 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 shoot. So, okay. New plan. Let's go cave spelunking. Yeah. I think that'll be the best idea. I think that'll work best. Oh, no! That was terrible! This is where I was actually going to go... Well, there's some iron there. If I can get down in here safely, we might be okay. That was terrible! I got hit down here by a damn slime because I looked away from the screen at the worst possible time. Well, that's two deaths on the tally, if anyone wants to keep track. All right, so how are we going to get down here safely? Maybe do a swoop-de-doop? Come on. Okay, yeah. No, that worked fairly well. I'll never get to that 15 gold I need to buy the slime staff. Baby slime staff's awesome, too. It's one of my favorites. I was really hoping to get a finch staff from the trees, but, you know, I've played two or three worlds in 1.4. I've never naturally come across a finch staff like that. So I don't know whether I'm cursed or blessed because the finch staff is actually quite garbage. Oh man, I really need... Well, at least we have this so we can see what we're doing a little bit, but I really need to get some slime spot. Man, this isn't gonna cut it. Is oh my god, I will just cut down through this. I need you to cooperate and die in the worst of ways. Thank you. Oh boy, I was gonna say, am I gonna be able to make it up? Oh my god, why can't I make it through anywhere with my freaking fat head? Jeez. So copper will pretty much be gathered just to sell. Because, honest to frig, copper never really has much use to it. Let me know, anyone that's played Terraria, do you ever bother with making copper gear? Or whatever your lowest ore has happened to be. Copper or iron in some cases. Or iron, geez, tin, I mean. I don't know if I've ever made it. I've always collected the lowest ore, but I don't know if I've ever gotten any use out of it. So this time around, at the very least, I will use it to take advantage, make some money. I'm wondering if maybe I should have went left back there. Depending on how far we make it in this run, I mean, there's always the potential I cannot beat this because I don't know if there's any secrets that'll prevent me from beating this. Like, I tried for the worthy. I couldn't make it past Skeletron in that, which made me really sad. I couldn't figure out what I was doing wrong, but my god, he was so fast. And I think I had the fastest boots I could get, so I could not get away from him enough to do anything. So I'm hoping there won't be any tricks like that to really screw the pooch here. Is that a single piece of blue sand? It is. It looks like we can continue to go to the right here. So let's dig through here really quickly. Let this water out. Dig up so we can place a torch down. Okay, this is going to go down for a little bit, or I can just dig two spots out and go over. Ooh, now we're getting choices. I wish some of these choices would lead to a freaking treasure or two. Okay, that doesn't really seem like it. Yeah, that's a dead end over that way, so we will continue this way. That's one good thing. Ah! I heard the tick, too. I was scratching my arm, and I couldn't do anything about it. Well... There goes that 2 silver. All right, no finch staff, like always. I can't get a finch staff to save my life. But at the very least, man, how do I only have 5 gel? I can go up there and really make this look bad by using a leaf wand. I'm pretty sure it's not gonna come out pink. I feel like it's gonna come out green. So it's probably going to ruin my plant, yeah. I was going to have leaves for the housing stuff, but the green leaves seem so out of place. I'm just destroying her house at this point. the green leaves are just so out of place here. I don't know. I mean, clashing, I guess, but I don't know. This is not doing it for me. And I'm almost out of wood. And I've only dealt with one of these damn spots so far. Good thing I have a hammer. Where's my hammer? I can at least... Oh, good. I was going to say, can you round edges out? Because I wasn't sure if you could or not. Really? Oh, my God. You're useless. You're useless. Can hardly see anything. Man, I didn't real. No. Get away from me, you little jerk. I could bring him to the surface and have a garden gnome, but screw that mess. I just wanted him dead. Recall potions, that's going to be beneficial at least. Let's get those up there so we can at least teleport back to places if we need to. I never know or knew until one of... Ooh, I will definitely take that. That'll let me step up a little bit higher. I think that's how it works anyway. Iron skin too, wow. But, how is it that works? Okay, you hit up. But I didn't learn until recently that... shoot, now I forget what I was gonna say again. Oh, that's a frig of my... What's happening? Why was I being hurt? Well, no, seriously, what was hurting me? Weird. Am I glitching into that block? Yeah, I'm definitely glitching into that block. How the hell is that a thing? Tungsten, is that the equivalent of silver? I'm not sure, but soon enough, I think we're going to need to make our next pickaxe. Which means I'm going to need to make a forge, which means I'm going to need more slime, which means I'm going to need more wood. There's our last tombstone. Let's pick it out. Oh, screw it. We don't need it that bad. It can stay. It can stay. Get away from me, you damn bat. Thank you for... What was that? Oh, no. I don't know what that was. It dropped out of the enemy. What's this? Darkness. Decreased light vision. Why was I blind? Oh, I must have been blind from the bat that hit me earlier, I guess. Damn it! Why'd I jump? Jumping was the biggest mistake I could have made. Yeah, I'm blind again. Oh, slime glitched out. Take advantage of that. Oh, no, we can hit him. Oh, there he goes. Goodbye, slime. Oh, no, not a man-eater. I'll never make it by... Ah, damn it! Well, there's one gold gone. I gotta go back for that. Money means everything to us at the moment. I guess these ones, the pre-hard mode guys, are called snatchers, not man-eaters like I thought. Come here, Pirani. If I can help it, you will never get near me. Same with you, Jungle Slime. I'm just trying to get to my money. I think I may have passed it, honestly. I wasn't paying attention to where I died. I don't remember being in this, but considering it's still lit up, I will assume... that we've been over this way. Yeah, there's my death. So, we'll just play this a little more careful. I really do need to get underground, focusing hard on some gathering stuff, like hearts and stuff. We desperately need hearts. We need, land chest. I will definitely take that. Another stepping stool. Great. So, I'm gonna ask. I make it no secret, I watch a lot of Chippy's Couch. I watch pretty much everyone. Actually, I've watched all of his Let's Plays over the last year or so. So the question is, when it comes to chests, what's your opinion? Leave them where they are or pick them up so you don't annoyingly grab the same ones over or search through the same ones over and over again? I'm in the camp of the latter. I hate leaving a damn chest because it annoys the holy livid hell out of me. Boomerang. Grenades. I'm happy about the wood. But man, I would love something a little more special. Yes, keep tearing through these slimes. I'd be screwed without this sword. So this sword was a definite godsend. Got ourselves another natural cave, but I'm afraid that drop will kill me, so I'm not going to test that one right now. I mostly want to stick to the surface at the moment, because, ugh, these jumps. I want to see right where everything is. We know the jungle's to the left because, you know, we went by it. So that means our dungeon's going to be to the super far right. And I'm thinking, wherever mid-world is here, I did make a medium-sized world, so let's go into the map real quick. We'll have to make a little spot here, so we'll have, you know, a teleport hub, so we can actually teleport around a little bit to make things a little, you know, a little less nuisance-y, a little better overall. Okay, this ominous cave is too inviting. I can't resist it. I've got to go down in this one. I don't know what that was that went flying down through here, but it worries me a little bit. Because, oh, okay, it was just a blue slime. It was moving. It was like a creature in the night type deal. It's like, you follow down behind this thing, you're as good as dead. But no, we should be fine with it just being a slime, right? I don't have any room, huh? What are we going to get rid of? I could always remake this. It's not like, maybe that is something we could do this time. Make the best weapon in the game. The, Zenith, I think it is now. I've never put in the effort to make any of those things. We don't need that right there. I really need to get myself a little storage area set up as well. But I don't know where I'm going to put that is the problem. I like having my main hub in this central part of the world. But I don't know we'll be able to get away with that this time around. Boy, this place is really paying off compared to the other. Okay, nothing much up in there. So right or left? Ooh, right leads to cobwebs. Which, we do need cobwebs to make a bed. Also leads to our silver equivalent of tungsten. I wish I had a thing so I could get the worm, but unfortunately that's not something we can do at the moment. Oh yeah, I actually meant to touch on this a little bit too. So, I'm sure you've noticed I'm doing this series without a face cam. And the reason is, it's a series I plan on recording like whenever I get free time to record. Outside of what I have. The closest... Oh my god, just pick, you jerk. The closest thing I have to a recording schedule, but the whole thought premise here. Oh, look at those freaking killer reaction times! I didn't totally accidentally press the jump button. Not at all. I can't see a damn thing. Let's get a torch down at the very least. Would you kindly, jerk? That's what I should have called you, jerky. Now, I see the pressure plate. Let's go for that. God only knows where the other thing is. I mean, it's obviously right there. Yeah, we definitely made the right choice. But the whole reason I'm not using a face cam... Why is he using a freaking... Oh, that's annoying. He uses a freaking hammer or an axe on stone trees. But I digress. The whole reason I am not using the face cam is... Recording this, I want to be able to record whenever I can, like, even if I'm not feeling super duper well. So, this is one of those situations. No, I don't know why you tinged at me. Okay, I can safely touch there. Okay, we can safely... Oh, I missed that. I saw it too late, guys. I saw it too late. I'm going to die because I am not on my weapon, and there are so many enemies around. Whew! Whew, might have set up a campfire here and just recover a little bit. Uh-oh. Fairy, get away from me! You are always a jinx! Take me to the left and we'll... You damn thing. That doesn't really help me as much as you think it would. Ooh, look at that fancy house! Look at that! That's what you're leading me to, isn't it? You're leading me to the fancy house. Oh my god, that house is beautiful. What the hell? Like, totally representing gay pride right there, right? I'm guessing it's just... Ah! Alright, so what I've gone and done in the meantime, while night was going through, I could have continued outward, but we need a spot. We desperately... What the hell? Oh, spawn point. We desperately need the spot that we could start putting some stuff away, so I'm a stickler for... I'm a stickler for stuff being in its proper spot. So let's rename this. Down to the bottom. There it is. we'll name this our potions chest. Actually, let's make this a little more precise. Buffs. Because I want specifically buffs in this chest. Healing potions will go into a different chest. Empty bottles always go with this stuff with me, so it works out that way, right? Put that in here. Alright, so I'm thinking now, I want to, or need to, and I need to get my water out of the way. I didn't realize they even put it back up in front of the damn screen. Wait, I didn't know you could make an enchanted boomerang. I've only ever found them. Huh. That's cool. I mean, kind of useless to me now, but that's actually really cool. I did not know that was a thing. So, what am I looking for? You guys tell me, because I clearly don't know. I know what it is I'm looking for. I can't make it because I did not have my stone with me. I need a furnace. So this, I will plop right up here. So this is going to be my little hub for stuff like this, my crafting. Obviously, it's going to have to be bigger over time. But for now, this little area should do starting out. I'm thinking expand over to about here, just to the edge of this, because I don't want to destroy the natural trees, because I can't actually put green in place of it. It would look terrible. And over this way, if need be, I can go to about here. And this is going to be my whole chest area, just as, yeah, I guess we're making this as our main base. And I've also, because it's really bugging me, I've got to fix that. I never noticed the awful gap that's all along there. Let me know if you guys noticed it in the comments down below, because I'm sure some of you were probably just screaming at me, like, fix that ugly mess. I may not be able to use leaves like I had planned. We'll see. I feel like the law of Kirky is really kicking my ass hard in this one. You guys saw me make it past the jungle that one time I tried after I got this sword. Can't do it now, for the life of me. These jerks right here, the damn bats. They won't let me make it anywhere. They just keep decimating me as soon as I step into this damn place. Get out of here. And I hate stopping to fight, because in the jungle, the moment you stop to fight, that's when you're doomed. It gets even worse in hard mode. The enemies, they don't know how to F off. They really don't. If we could get by this damn jungle, I'm home free for getting to mid-world so I can start my freaking pylon system. I mean, so I can start putting people in homes. I really should have made a spot back that way too, now that I think about it, on the beach. For the, if I die, I'll do that. For the angler and whoever else, party girl at the moment. Okay, little jerkweed's following. Oh, he didn't follow me all the way. Come on. Come on, little jerkweed. Yeah, screw you, buddy. You're now mine. A golden gnome? What? Oh, garden gnome. Okay, I was gonna say, I've never seen a golden gnome before. So they're supposed to increase your luck. I assume you have to keep it with you and use it. Otherwise, it wouldn't make much sense. Let's see if we get lucky. Hey, a finch staff. Awesome. Finally, something worked out for us. Oh, looks like we're into another night. Damn it, I was really hoping to evade or avoid even this. That's fine. Grab the water leaf while we can. Ooh, pyramid. Yes, please. I love how if you dig underneath, I'll do that again real quick. Torch, please. Get out of here. Oh, no. Screw it. Screw it. The sand above changes color as it goes down. That's great. I would assume... Oh, my God. Look at all the money. I would assume this is another characteristic of this world. Sandstorm in a bottle. Yes, please. But playing normal worlds, I almost never, ever see a pyramid. Out of 800 hours, I've seen maybe two pyramids. They're very rare. Man, my inventory is really getting full up here. We definitely cannot let ourselves die at this point, right? Because of all the money I picked up in there, I've got to have a good amount on me. Will you quit following me? Oh, look at all these flowers. That means I am probably near this point I want to be. Oh, if you noticed, the music has changed. And it's because if you go to a certain seed, you can find a party girl there and you can unlock alternate music. Once you do that just once, it stays unlocked forever. So that was something I did ages ago when the seed was first discovered. Alright, so I would love to see if we're mid-world, but enemies will... Oh my god, get away from me, you freaking demon. We're gonna lock ourselves in for the night. This way we don't have to worry about dying. Okay, so there's one big flaw in the music. Oh god, there's so many slimes. There's one big flaw in the music going the way that it is. Or having the alternate music on. It doesn't loop clean. What I mean by that is, there's a clear, abrupt stop, which is a little unfortunate. So what I'm looking to do here, I had to dig some stuff out because I don't have any dirt blocks. I've actually got to go elsewhere to dig out more. I want to level this area off as best I can, so we can at least have a flat area for our new homes to be built on. But it looks like if I want to do that, I'm going to have to... Hoo-ah! Really? You're going to make me platform this? I forgot I had a double jump, so I don't need to put something like that there. I really don't. I can jump for days. So I still do need to go over there, though. The whole point of going... Oh, no, 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 no. I don't think so. I am not ready for a goblin freaking army right now. So screw you, buddy. Screw you, buddy. There's two things I want over in here. I want some of this, and I want some of the dirt. They really want to push a freaking goblin army on me, don't they? Ooh, what are you? I mean, aside from the most beautiful thing I've ever seen. Please die. He's dropping money every time I hit him. Oh, maybe he's not. No, he definitely is. It's just not giving it to me. It disappears. Wow, you're a tough one, huh? What is your health? Too much, apparently. Stop hitting him so I can see. 900, I think it showed. I'm probably just gonna have to tuck myself away again at night. Or for the night. Let him come down. Let him come down, Finch. The sooner we get him killed off, the better. And I can juggle him right here fairly well.
47 gold?! Holy crap!
Holy crap! Oh, I really don't want to die now! Man, are they ever pushing for this goblin army. I'm killing about one of these every 10 to 20 seconds. Go away, I can't get anything built because of it. I'm really glad that I can move fast because of my jumping. Man, is it ever tedious to deal with this mess. So I was just going to... I gotta remove that workbench as well. I have no room for anything. I just realized, like, my inventory is completely tapped out. Let's plant the marigold if it'll let us. There we go. That's one free space. But yeah, I can't really get much done like I wanted to. I was going to make this just one big area, but I think I'll split it off into a big room and a small room. Or maybe I'll extend this out that way a little bit further so the rooms can be a little more symmetrical. That way I should have three rooms here, and hopefully that'll be enough when the time comes that I'll be able to deal with not needing an NPC, or I'll be able to get my pylon. So I think right about there should even out. I don't know. I didn't count. I'm eyeballing it. But that looks fairly even, I think. Great. What do you guys think? You guys could I think the one on the left is actually one bigger. Oh, you jerks. You're getting on my damn last nerves here. No, 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 no. You're not getting away. You're not getting away. You're not getting away. You're getting on my nerves, so you're going to die. Look, see what I mean? See what I mean? So annoying, man! I noticed a problem I was having with Terraria once before has come back. There's little hitches that keep... Well, you saw a little one when the second goblin came in. Now I gotta shrink this down by one. To be even. At least I think. You know one thing that's really annoying? when you're doing this and it places a bunch of freaking wall outside of your boundaries, damn it. Like it did back here. And I've got to fix that one spot. Actually, you know what? I could do this instead to make it look like, yeah, this is where you go down and through. And I could do the same here. Like, this is where you go. It doesn't look good, though. Whatever. I don't care. I spent far too long on this. Now the question becomes, is this valid housing? Well, I'd say so. They were not long moving in. Well, at least we have people here. We just don't have the right people here. Hoping Hermit the Crab moves in there. And by Hermit the Crab, I obviously mean the merchant. I don't know why, but he's usually got a name with an H for me for some reason. I just need a little more stone as well. Ow, I did not see you there, friend. I wanted to end off with something big, but in all honesty, in an opening episode to this, all it is a lot of mining and searching. And that's what next episode will be as well. It's just mining and trying to get stuff to make ourselves stronger, like hearts and accessories. And we might maybe take on Slime King or something along those lines. But I need rubies for that. So, you know, or a natural slime rain. That would be great. Hopefully that does not happen in this video. If it does, I will bail so fast. Wow, that does not run much closer. I have literally one stone brick or gray brick left. It does not run much closer than that, ladies and gents. So, yep, this is definitely going to be our home base in the middle area. I don't know why I always put the outer lip like that. It's always been a preference. And we're still not done here quite, because as I'm sure you've noticed, oh my god, switch it. This area here defies all laws of physics. Ow, I bit my tongue. It defies all laws of physics. So I know there's a beam you can make. I just don't know how it's made. And without the guide being near us, it makes it a little trickier. I thought it'd be with the just right here, but that does not seem to be the case. The bad thing with having to search right now, I thought I'd show you real quick. I'm uploading a video right now. I'm doing a quick search to see how to make wooden beams. I know it's terrible that I have to do that, but where I'm uploading this, this is a 2.5 gigabyte file, so I've been uploading it throughout the evening. Only 32% done. It's been uploading for like 5-6 hours at this point, but it makes it hard because I can't actively search fast. This is my internet when I'm uploading. It's basically dial-up. Yes, it is really taking this long to load a single page. I know it sucks. I really know it sucks. Okay, so the thing I'm missing is a sawmill. I have a sawmill, just not here. Shoot. And you know what? We might actually have the stuff if I work through this. We need an anvil. We'll place that in her place. That'll let us make chain, which in turn should let us make... I wish there was a button that went directly into this crafting window. There it is. There's the sawmill. We've got duplicates of freaking items at this point. Of crafting things. Crafting stations. That's fine. Picnic table. Let's give these guys a picnic table since we're here. There you go. You can't use it. I mean, you're all locked in, but there you go. You have a picnic table. The bunny's coming over to enjoy it. Now, beams. Bench, bar... bar stool. I'm gonna grab this loom right now because I'm gonna need that at some point. I'll put one here down in with him, and the other one will be saved for once I get back to the other spot. I'll toss that since it's just a single brick. Now back to my journey of wooden beams. Finally, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 should do the trick, I would say. Yeah, I'm not as keen on this music as I thought I would be. Yeah, I think this should do nicely. Maybe we can even... No, doubling up doesn't look as good, does it? Sorry, Bunny. Kind of just got in the road there. All right, so we've got basically... Great, thank you. We basically got everything we want to do. I'll make some homes here in my off time. And yeah, I think this is a pretty good spot to call it. I mean, we've done quite a bit today. Wow, I can just jump up in here now. So, yeah, if you happen to enjoy this video, as always, leave it a big old thumbs up. Ah, damn it, the party girl was over in the other spot. I should have changed the music while I had the chance. If you want to help me on way 2.5k subs I mentioned earlier, subscribe to that button down below. I'd much appreciate that. Check out these videos off to the side here if you haven't already. And yeah, I don't have too awful much left to say, so see you for part two, which will hopefully be up within a few days. We'll see. See you guys in the next one.